I think I want to talk about protest. I want to talk about quality. I think many times what happens is, because we are in the alternative space, we are non-profits, we are people who are scared, who is going to fund us, where is the funding coming from, how am I going to manage, we keep quiet. I don't think wars have been won on quietness or quietude. It has been won on people going out there and saying their mind. I think Faiz Ahmed Faiz said it very well when he talked bull. You have the voice, you speak, and we don't speak. We laugh, we concur, and we keep quiet. Why do we concur? Why do we not come up and say that ye bilkul theek nahi hai? This is not enough. I want to bring the topic back to the child. I think we have, I'm a Tamil, so we say Raman anda enna, Ravanan anda enna. It doesn't matter which, who is there and who's putting out the rules and everything. Most of us are flying below the radar. And most of us are trying to see how can we make this happen. That is the alternative space. And today, I want to say, let's claim that alternative space. As has been told by everyone, people have said it. And I think there is more wisdom and more knowledge and more expertise that side of this mic than this side of the mic. So I'm not saying that I know. I'm saying that we as a group have never come together. We as a group do not feel that we have the time or we have the energy, because we are running behind goals and you know what we want to do. We are running behind children. We are saying, bachchon ke liye ye cheez to dena hai. Bachchon ke liye ye bahut zaruri hai. And we look at it from the point of view of the child and what is it that the child wants? What does the child like? And we don't look at what is it that the government is doing. The RTE has come. It has almost gone, I suppose, and new things are going to come back. I don't know how many of us have really broken our heads over what is RTE doing for us. I don't think we have. We have gone ahead and we've done whatever it is that we have to do. But I think the time has come for protest. I think we need to say that the next revolution that we want, the next freedom struggle that we want, should be on the basis of education. So I stand here for that invisible child. I'm not talking here for a child who has everything and needs alternative education. There are those 2 crore and more children. We talk about 300 million children in school today, and 50% of them cannot read. But if you go actually into the slums, you go into the villages, you'll find it's not 50%. It's a very, very nice figure to say. But I will write on that figure. But first, I have a small little film to show you, a video, a short video. So we'll have that video and then turn the discussion over back again to the child, that invisible child.
Slums of Delhi's Govindpuri district, Katha Lab School stands out for its bright yellow and white walls. Despite its massive growth since it first began, Katha is determined to breathe life into the refugee colony and has educated over 7,000 students.
So we have theme-based learning. There is a topic. That topic we integrate with math, science, language, integrate karte hain. ताकि उस बच्चे को बार-बार 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 रिवीजन मिले वो बच्चा सीखे और लॉन्ग लाइफ तक वो अपने माइंड में सेट करके रखे वो कभी नहीं भूल सकता सर वो एक्टिविटी को कथा ने हर फील्ड में मौका दिया है कि हम पीछे ना रहें हम आगे बढ़ते 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 जाएं
Every year Katha chooses a theme to center its education around and it comes I think from this idea that like all our subjects, we're not just learning them because like we're supposed to be learning them. Like they're tied to something real, something that affects our lives, something that's like actually important to making the world a better place.
I want to be dance teacher.
I want to be doctor. I want to be scientist. I want to be doctor. I want to be dress designer.
And we do so many songs. So I've noticed that it'll be really hard for them to remember a few lines like in a foreign language, which is for any like first time language speaker. But as soon as we learn a song, they remember it for months. We've done a song that actually comes from my country, Mexico, and it's like an indigenous resistance song, so it fits Katha's theme. And the kids learned it in Spanish, English, and Hindi, so that was really amazing.
Story, हम इसलिए लेते हैं कि story क्योंकि एक बहुत ऐसी चीज है जो कि सबको बांध के रखती है और सब उसको बड़े इंटरेस्ट से सुनते हैं, देखते हैं, क्रिएटिविटी उसमें बहुत है.
Stories help students rediscover their roots and culture, parts of their lives that are easily forgotten in the city. Stories are incorporated even in co-curricular activities. Katha balances emotional and academic growth to encourage holistic learning, from chemistry to robotics.
रोबोटिक्स में हम अलग अलग तरह के रोबोट बनाते हैं जो 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 हमें प्रॉब्लम आते हैं उससे हम सॉल्व करते हैं. हमारी टीचर अगर हमें समझ नहीं आता है तो वो एक्टिविटी के द्वारा समझाती हैं.
जो हमको हमारे जो सब्जेक्ट्स लगते हैं अगर उसमें हमें कोई भी कॉन्सेप्ट समझ नहीं आता वो हम रोबोटिक्स द्वारा सीखते हैं. मैंने सबसे पहले फोर व्हीलर कार सीखी थी बनानी, फिर उसके बाद क्रेन बनाई, फिर उसके बाद पुशिंग बॉक्स बनाया.
यहाँ बहुत सारे सब्जेक्ट तो हैं लेकिन एकेडमी भी है जैसे वुडक्राफ्ट, टेलरिंग, बेकरी एक्सेट्रा.
गरीब बच्चों के लिए तो बहुत ही अच्छा है, मतलब उनके लिए जो फैसिलिटीज है यहाँ पे प्राइवेट स्कूल के जैसे.
इन दिस स्मॉल स्पेस कथा हैज मैनेज्ड टू अपलिफ्ट चिल्ड्रन एंड देयर मदर्स, गिविंग वॉइस to disabled and marginalized communities. In providing women with tools to tackle difficulties, Katha extends itself to families, creating a lasting impact.
लेकिन ऐसा हुनर जिससे आप अपने परिवार को, अपने आसपास के लोगों को अच्छा जीवन दे पा रहे हैं, अच्छा जीवन से मतलब.
Katha is dedicated to making each child realize their full potential. It will work relentlessly till no child lives in poverty.
Pachni jal ki rani hai, jeevan uska paani hai, haath lagao dar jayegi, baahar nikalo mar jayegi, sara paani pi jayegi.
I come from a Tamil, you know, we had that anti-Hindi agitation. So I have a block over here when it comes to Hindi. But when I came here, I found that children knew less Hindi than I knew. I could read and the children couldn't read. So the whole idea was, how could we put reading in front? So Katha was started to enhance the joy of reading in 1988. And all through we've been looking at how do children read? How do societies and how do communities and how do children learn? Is there a way in which children are learning where we can look at story? In 1987 or 88, there was a national sample survey which said that children said, it's not that we don't want to go to school, but schools are so dull and boring and textbooks are so dull and boring. So in 1990, when I started the school, by then Katha was making books for children. We started with making books. I said, let's not have textbooks at all, let's have storybooks. So all the teaching that's happening, all the doctors and engineers and artists and bakers who have got all over, we have a baker sitting in Iceland and doing bakery, God knows what he's doing over there, but he's baking over there. And he came back, and we have IBM students, people working in IBM have come, all suited and coated. The other day, I go to the school, and there is this Lal Batti car. I said, oh my God, I think I missed some government officer coming. You know, we are all very scared of government people coming to the school. Very, very scared. We don't know why they are coming and when they are going to say, close out the school or you cannot do this. I really don't know. So I went inside and I find that this guy, is one of our students. She's got into the IAS and she is there in that Lal Batti car and she's coming and she's one of our role models over there. So when you're looking at how children learn, they learn in invisible ways. And we need to allow that invisibility to be there. They learn because they are curious. They learn because they want to be critical thinkers. You leave it to them, and I completely agree with Sugato when he said that, you know, when a child is creative, the child can learn. The other day, I had gone to the school, and I saw this little child who was about maybe 5, 6 in our Junjunwadi. We have cluster education right from 1990. So here is this child, she's standing on this little Kadapa slab and she's trying to draw something on the blackboard, on the whiteboard. Then she goes and asks another child, and I don't know what she's whispered, but she comes back and this boy comes and draws a flower. The usual, no, he comes and draws the house, which is the usual thing that all children draw. But this child looks at it and she's drawing a flower without taking her the pen off the board. Now, that is creativity. For a four-year-old, that is creativity. Do we allow that to grow? When we say that the wave comes like this and the child draws the wave like this, we say no, that's not the wave goes. But we don't know how the wave really goes. Can we stop and think before we tell the child what she should draw or what she should think? Many times what happens is the protest that we have to make is not with the government, it is with ourselves, it is with our communities, it is for our child. I think the government is that invisible thing where we have people like CCS who will go there and defend and get anything that has to be done, and we can all be with you and be behind you. But we need to say that there should be grassroots work happening. And we should continue to work with the child in focus and not looking at RTE or this or that or anything. No, I'm wrong. I think we should look at it, but we should look at it through a sideways glance and not focus on that. We should be focused on what we are doing. Now, in Katha, what we did was, many years ago, we are very slow. I think we agonize a lot, we think a lot, we do, and then we take half a step back, then we move forward. I think it's not innovation, but innovativeness that is needed. It's not one-time innovation. You have to be constantly innovative. Constantly looking at the child and say, kya karna hai, kaisa karna hai, abhi kya main theek kar rahi hu, ya theek nahi kar rahi. What is it that I want for her when she's reading? So when we started doing that in 1990, and then in 1995, we started the Katha School of Entrepreneurship, because I thought that it would be good. We got the first computer over there. So I was thinking when Sugato was saying, because we also work in Govindpuri, I was wondering whether it was one of our children, because in 1995, we had brought computers into our classroom. We had one computer which had been donated. I said, "Theek hai, aap school mein aap bhej do, and let us look at what is happening." And in the school, by the time we came to 1998, we had 13 computers which had been donated to the school, all old computers which were not being used. But the children were using it. In 2001, I remember when we were starting work with our street children, who till then had been very, very, sorry to say, invisible. I said I was very naive and very stupid. But when we noticed street children and we took them into the school the first time, the children were saying, बड़े होने के बाद क्या बनना है हाँ टीचर बनना है टीचर बनना है टीचर बनना है टीचर बनना है वी वर सिटिंग इन द कंप्यूटर रूम एंड वन चाइल्ड सेड कंप्यूटर बनना एंड देन द रेस्ट ऑफ द चिल्ड्रन आल्सो सेड कंप्यूटर बनना एंड नाउ व्हेन यू लुक एट यू नो हाउ मेनी चिल्ड्रन हैव ग्रेजुएटेड यू सॉ द रोबोटिक्स लैब ओवर देयर वी ऑलवेज से यू नो ये ऐसा वाले बच्चों के लिए यू नो गिव देम स्किल्स और गिव देम दिस और गिव देम दैट बट व्हाई नॉट बिग आइडियाज फॉर एवरीवन. Why not say that big ideas are needed for every child? How do we give them big ideas? I think what we found was working through storybooks, working through books, and so Katha as a publisher has been publishing books so that we can fill the spaces that children occupy with storybooks, fantasies, fiction, science fiction. Supposing we can give all these things to children,
then will they start reading on their own? How do we get them to read on their own? These were some of the challenges that we had.
So I think that, you know, there are three ideas that I would like to put before this very august and very, very learned and people with experience and expertise in the field of preschool and child education. When I look at the Katha journey, I think there's one learning that I can take from the Katha learning. Many things, but one thing that we have been looking at is how do we take what we have been innovating and what we've been creating in the Katha Lab School to support the government schools. We started this work in 2002-2003 because somehow I felt that most of our children are going into government schools. By some accounts, it's 80% of our children going into government schools. We have to see that we, as people who care and people who want equity and equality for our country, in quality and in education, we have to do that. So it was this thing of going into the school, government schools, and helping them to read. So we started what we call the I Love Reading campaign. The campaign became a place where, you know, lots and lots of schools came. Then the government came and asked us, can you work with us? Can you take it into our schools? And till now, there has been the Delhi school system, there has been the Gujarat school system, Jharkhand, various school systems which have come and said, I think this is a good way for children to read. Now, I think that reading as the basis, as the cornerstone, as the lodestone for all learning is an absolute must. And today I didn't hear anyone, I may be sorry, I am wrong maybe, but I didn't hear the importance that we are giving to reading. How do you open up a computer and how do you do a hole in the wall if I cannot read anything at all? How do I do that? I can drop down things, I can do things, but how do I learn? How do I move forward? I believe in teachers. I believe that in our country we've had gurus and we've had gurus for a reason. Gurus are good, we need to have them. But if you don't have good gurus, what do you do about it? I think the way in which we can move would be to say, okay, here are the schools and can we go into the government system? So from 2004, we went into the government school system. Slowly, slowly, we signed the MOU with the government and then we started working with the government. And now, government has given us three schools. They gave us three schools to run and two of them became best in their districts. They gave us two more schools. And now I'm thinking, can we have model schools? So that is one thing that I would like to suggest to this group over here of alternative educators. Is it possible for us to say that the 300 million children that we have in our country today, out of which 50% cannot talk, probably the 50% are children who are coming from non-literate families. Is it possible for us to say that every child will teach another child? If we say that a child who can read, helping a child who cannot read, we can forget government. Government, let them keep working on their things and let them come up with new policies and things like that. Let us go ahead and gung-ho, say that, yes, I want every child to read. So if we can put one child with another child and bring them to read. The second thing that I would really like for it to happen, you are all running good schools. We've been hearing a lot about the innovations. What awesome ideas came up today. Such lovely ideas. Each one has been thinking and thinking only of the child. It's been child-centric thinking that happened today, right through the day, right through the day. Now, supposing we say each of these schools can have a link with a government school or have what in Katha we are calling the reading school chain. So you have one school which is reading very well, then you have model schools, and then you take it from there into the I Love Reading, where a lot of government schools are beginning to read in whichever language it is happening. Supposing a reading school chain can be developed, I think there is a way in which our country can look at equity and equality in quality and in quality education. Supposing this idea that, you know, Mr. Swaroop gave and somebody else before that, I think it was your idea, saying that supposing we have an alternative space which we can create and CCS creates that space and we say that Non-profits are, we are very difficult people. We never come together. Maybe you'll be lucky and you'll be able to bring us together. But all of us stand for our own things, and then we are all, as I said earlier, very busy doing our own things. So many times we don't get to do the kind of things that we should do for that higher policy level. We don't go into the corridors of power. We remain in the grassroots, very happy to remain in the grassroots. But supposing there is an intervention that can be created over here, and we are in a position to come there, and if a reading chain can be created, and if a standing up for the child and for quality, if we can say that every child deserves the school that she deserves, not just what her parents can pay for. If we can say that and if we can stand with that. So I want to finish with just one very small story. So when I was a small child, we used to go, we were a big family. So normally that is where I learned about Avayar and Aram Cheyya Virumbu. That was the first thing that I learned, Aram Cheyya Virumbu. Aram is generosity, Cheyya to do, and Virumbu, desire. She didn't say go out and do and go out and give. She said desire to do good, desire to give. And I think that desiring is something that is very, very important. Now, when we look at children and how can they desire, I always go back again to the days when at night we would all sit down together as a family and we'd be sitting in this big circle, and my grandmother would be giving out the food to everybody. She would have mixed the food, and we'd all get one handful. And if any one of us did not eat up the handful because she was telling such a lovely story, we are looking at her, there would be no more handfuls to go because we are such a big family. So it was just that one round that would go, and we had to eat our food, which was put onto our palm. And on the night of the third crescent, we called it the Moonram Pirai. On the night of the third crescent, we had to go and find the moon in that sky of stars before we could sit down to eat. The Moonram Pirai, or the third crescent, is this tiny thing. It's like a nail pairing in the sky, just a luminous nail pairing in the sky. And you have to find it. And I remember many times we'll go and say, Amma, Mama, there, angarka, angarka. We point out to her. And she'll say, where? And she's looking. But she's looking somewhere else. I am pointing out, and I know where I'm pointing out, but she's looking elsewhere. Is she looking at my fingertip? Is she looking at that open sky? The distance between any pointed finger and the sky is a journey that all of us have to take on our own. And all of us as teachers have to take that journey with our teachers, with our children. We have to point out and then be satisfied to allow that child to follow her own path and reach the star, which is her star. Thank you.